I'm interested in how people learn motor skills. And when we think about learning, we think about best practices. And when we think about best practices, we typically are thinking about the course content. And I'm going to introduce you tonight to some strategies that are supplements to course content in terms of helping people to improve skill memory. Before I do that, I'd like to take you for a short visit into my lab so that you can understand what skill memory is about and to give you some background into how we came up with some of these technologies that might help us supplement instruction. So you come to the lab and you sit at a table and you look at a computer monitor and you have your hands on keyboards and the computer monitor presents some visual signals and the visual signals direct what your fingers should do, so what keys you should present in what order. And we have you learn some pretty complex sequences. Now, in a typical experiment, we'd have you practice this for about 30 minutes. And then we'd ask you to come back about 7 hours later. And most everyone in this room here would do perfectly fine, and they'd reproduce that skill relatively well. But we can tweak that experiment just a little bit by having you learn that skill for 30 minutes, introduce a second skill, not the same skill, but similar, and have you practice that for 30 minutes, and then come back 7 hours later, sometime in the evening, and in this case, you'd exhibit quite a bit of forgetting. Now, we can tweak that experiment one more time. It's an important tweak. And in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to introduce a technology where we can place a coil next to your head. And that coil will induce an electric field through a certain set of cells in the brain. In this particular case, the ones we're interested in for the skills I'm looking at is a set of cells that run from the ear to the crown of the head. And this is called the primary motor cortex. And in this experiment, what we're going to do is we're going to electrically stimulate after you practice the first skill. And that electrical field in this particular case actually down-regulates or turns down the activity in the motor cortex. And if we do that, we practice a skill for 30 minutes, and we come back, and then we have the stimulation, and we come back 7 hours later, what happens is we see forgetting again. Now, there are a couple of important things to take from those experiments. One, that if you're trying to learn a skill, what you do immediately after the skill is very, very important. And two, for the sort of skills I study, activation in the motor cortex is critical to actually remembering those skills at a later time. Now, the question we're asking is, can we take advantage of this and actually improve the effectiveness of that interval right after practice? And there are a number of ways we can do that. The first thing we looked at, it's a very nice intervention, is to sleep. In this particular case, we do the same experiment. We have people practice for about 30 minutes, and then we give the interfering material, and of course, we see the forgetting 7 hours later. But in this particular experiment, what we do is we introduce a nap in between the first practice and the interfering material. In this particular case, when the person comes back 7 hours later, they now remember the skill quite well. Now, I'm in kinesiology, and of course, we're very interested in exercise. And with exercise, we can do something very similar to the nap. We have people practice for 30 minutes, and then we give the interfering material a little later on. But in this particular case, we now have people exercise. And the exercise in this case is about 20 minutes of moderate intensity exercise on a bicycle ergometer. And once again, what we see here is the exercise allows the memory to be remembered very well 7 hours later. So it's almost like the exercise and the nap is providing some protection to this memory that you're developing from the initial bout of practice. Now, you'll recall a little while ago I mentioned an important area is that strip of cells that run right above the ear to the crown of the head called the motor cortex. And what we can look at here is the importance of that region too. We can actually look to see whether that region is important because we think that's the region that's actually being activated when we exercise and nap. And we can do that using a different technology that's depicted here in the picture. This is called transcranial direct current stimulation. And this allows us, again, to induce an electric current into those cells. But in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to put an electric current there that activates those cells. So now we're going to train for 30 minutes. We're going to apply the stimulation while we train. And then 7 hours later, we're going to come back, and lo and behold, once again, you remember the skill quite well. Now, the question is, are people actually taking advantage of these sorts of strategies? And the truth of the matter is, this device right here now is commercially available, hard to believe, huh? $799 a pop from Halo Neuroscience. And of course, the arena that's very interested in complex movement learning are athletes. And now you see this with a lot of Division I programs are using this as part of their training program, the NBA and the NFL. What I'm hoping to do going forward is understand how these strategies help memory, and we're hoping to help people who have some deficits in motor learning, people who have maybe experienced some developmental disorder, or have experienced a stroke, or maybe a traumatic brain injury. Thank you for listening.